The Katapayadi is one of the ancient Indian systems of representing numbers with Sanskrit alphabets. It offers a convenient way to remember very large numbers by encoding them into sentences of prose or poetry. Some historians attribute the origin of this system to Vararuchi, a brilliant scholar from Kerala who lived during the 4th century CE. There are several examples of the Katapayadi being extensively used in the mathematics and astronomy works of scholars from Kerala of the 14th to the 18th century. In Malayalam, the regional language of Kerala, the Katapayadi system is colloquially known by the name Paral Pere or Akshara Samkhya. Katapayadi uses Sanskrit consonants to represent numbers of the decimal system. Thus, the first consonant ka is assigned to the numerical value 1. The second consonant ka is assigned the value 2. And so on till one gets to j, which is represented by 9, and nya by 0. The numbers are then assigned to the next set of 10 consonants in a similar manner. In this scheme, we therefore end up having multiple alphabets representing the same number. The number 1 is mapped to the alphabets ka, ta, pa, and ya, which when pronounced together gives Katapayadi, where adi in Sanskrit means etc. The vowels or swaraksharas are not assigned any numerical value. So, for example, k, ka, ke, kai, ko, kao, ki, and ki all represent the number 1. This scheme of mapping numbers to alphabets is summarized in a single line from the text Sadratnamala, a mathematical treatise written by the scholar Shankara Varman in 1819. With such a scheme, one can bundle the different alphabets together to form meaningful words and sentences that represent numbers. The vowels or swaras, which do not have any numerical significance, serves the purpose of embellishing the words and achieving poetic meter. A few simple rules have to be followed while encoding and decoding numbers under the Katapayadi system. This aphorism says that the numbers move in their place value from left to right. The least significant decimal place is written first on the left, and the most significant is written last on the right. The decoding would work from right to left. For example, the number 2359 will be written in Katapayadi as 9532, but has to be read as 2359. Here is another example. The name Rama would correspond to 25 in the Katapayadi system, but when read by application of this rule, Rama becomes an encoding for the number 52. Historically, more recent use of Katapayadi in some instances has not followed this sequence of decoding from right to left. The following verse from the Sadratnamala text explains the remaining rules for converting numbers into a coded form using Katapayadi. Once we understand how the Katapayadi system is designed, we can start playing around with the alphabets to come up with words, sentences or verses that represent various numbers. An example is the verse that appears in Sadratnamala that brilliantly illustrates the convenience of Katapayadi. When we decode this verse using the Katapayadi matrix, we get a series of digits that correspond to the value of pi, correct to 17 decimal places, with the last digit rounded off to 4. The decimal point is absent here, since Katapayadi does not have a way to encode it. It would be extremely difficult for anyone to remember the value of pi up to these many decimal places. Encoding its value into the verse makes it easy. A more involved example is the 14th century mathematician Madhava's use of Katapayadi to encode the values of the trigonometric sine function from 0 to 90 degrees in multiples of 3.75 degrees. In his table, the sine value for each angle appears as a short Katapayadi phrase. The table of values can be easily reconstructed by remembering these phrases in the right order. The Chandravakyas are another set of examples where Katapayadi is used. Written in the 4th century CE by Vararuchi, the Chandravakyas are a collection of sentences representing 248 numbers meant for calculating the position of the sun and the moon for any time of the year. These numbers were extensively used for computations of native almanacs and for predicting the position of the moon. Much later, in the 14th century CE, Madhava wrote down in his work Venvaroha a new set of sentences to encode similar numerical values to a much greater precision. One of the most fascinating examples of Katapayadi is its use in South Indian classical music. The melodic scales in Indian classical music are known as raga. In the South Indian classical music tradition, Melakarta is a collection of 72 ragas. The Melakarta ragas are also called Sampurna ragas or complete ragas, as they have all seven swaras or notes of the octave in both the ascending and the descending scales. The Melakarta are the parent ragas, from which many other melodic scales are derived. First propounded in the mid-15th century CE by Ramamatya, the Mela system of arranging ragas was revised and refined over centuries. The system that is used now was expounded by Venkatamakin in the 17th century. The Melakarta system uses Katapayadi to name the ragas. The first two syllables of the name of each raga represent the raga's position in the Melakarta sequence. Let's look at an example. The first two syllables of the raga Latangi, La and Tha, represent the number 63, which is the position of this raga in the Melakarta sequence. Similarly, the first two syllables of the raga Charukeshi is Katapayadi for the number 26, which is the raga's position in the Melakarta sequence. By knowing just the name of the Melakarta raga, one can therefore work out its number in the Melakarta system and from there establish its ascending and descending scales with the help of some simple mathematical functions like division and addition. It has to be noted that there are some Melakarta ragas, such as Chakravakam, Divyamani, Chitrambari, that does not follow this rule for a different reason. Another fascinating example of the use of Katapayadi comes from the Narayaniyam, a famous devotional hymn in Sanskrit written by the celebrated mathematician and linguist Melpathur Narayana Bhattathiri in the 16th century. The hymn concludes with the words Ayur Arogya Saukyam. Taken literally, these words are a promise of longevity, health and happiness that one would inherit in life. Interestingly, the words Ayur, Arogya, Saukhyam is more than just a wish. Applying Katapayadi to these words establishes the day on which Melpathur completed the work Narayaniyam. It represents the Kalidina Sankhya, which is the number of days since the start of the Kali Yuga as per the Malayalam calendar. The Kalidina Sankhya is a parameter that has been in use in Kerala for several centuries up to the present in astrology and astronomy. A very interesting possible manifestation of Katapayadi from a much earlier period comes from the epic Mahabharata. The original name for the epic, given by its author Vedavyasa, was Jaya. In the Katapayadi system, Jaya codes for 18, a recurring number in this epic. The Mahabharata is divided into 18 parvas or volumes. There are 18 chapters in the Bhagavad Gita, which belongs to the Mahabharata. The decisive battle of Kurukshetra lasted for 18 days. In that war, 18 Akshohinis participated. Perhaps the Katapayadi system existed even at the time when the Mahabharata epic was written several centuries earlier to BCE. Much of the works of our ancestors have got lost with the passage of time. Tangible recordings of their works in the form of manuscripts, often written on perishable material, have either got lost or are not accessible. Here, Shruti, or the oral tradition of acquiring wisdom through the spoken word, becomes important. Regardless of its antiquity, we do have a choice to revive such knowledge traditions. Only by becoming aware of these traditions and committing to their continued use can we keep their flow alive for the future generations.